Welcome to CEC Lectures. In my last few interactions with you, I have discussed the concept of chirality and enantiomerism with you in great details. Continuing the lecture further from there, today I shall be discussing stereochemistry of some reactions which involve inversion in configuration, retention in configuration, and racemization. But before I proceed with the reaction mechanisms of these reactions, let me first familiarize ourselves with the concept of inversion, retention, and racemization. So when does a retention or inversion takes place? It depends on the site of the molecule from which the reagent will attack the reactant. For this, I shall be discussing today stereochemistry of nucleophilic substitution reactions. Now, supposing a nucleophile, which is an electron-rich species and has affinity towards electron-deficient center, it can attack the stereo center in two ways. Like it can attack from the front side or from the back side. So when we talk of retention, inversion or racemization, we are dealing with chiral molecules. So on your screens, now you can see few slides, few examples that I have taken to illustrate what is retention and what is inversion in configuration. So if we see here, we have a substrate here, and when we look at this substrate, substrate is chiral in nature because it has an asymmetric carbon. Now you know an asymmetric carbon is a carbon which is attached to four different groups. In this case, it is attached to ethyl group, hydrogen, methyl and a group X. So we carry out the reaction with, say, reagent Y. And when the reaction is complete, we find that Y is occupying the same space in the product as X was occupied. What was the space of X in the substrate? So when we have carried out the reaction, we find that the product has the same shape, same structure, same orientation of groups in space. That means it has same configuration. That means that there has been retention in configuration. So that means if the reagent is attacking the reactant at the same phase from where the leaving group is departing, that means reaction is accompanied by retention in configuration. On the other hand, we can see that when we are carrying out the reaction of the same substrate with the same reagent Y, we are getting an entirely different molecule in which the orientation of group Y is opposite to the leaving group. So in this case, what has happened, there has been change in shape, change in orientation of groups in space. That means there has been change in configuration. So this reaction has been accompanied by inversion in configuration. So what we find that at a stereo, when the reaction is taking place at a stereo center by a particular reagent, two things can happen. That is, inversion in configuration can take place, or that is, retention in configuration can take place, or we can get a product which has an inverted configuration. Now let us imagine that this molecule can undergo reactions in both the ways. That is, it can react with Y to give us product B, and at the same time it can product with Y to give us product A. That means, what are we getting? We are getting a mixture of two products. That is, in one where there is inversion in configuration, and the other one where there is retention in configuration. So what are we getting here? We are getting here a racemic mixture. That is, racemic mixture is an equimolar mixture of A and the B forms, and the net rotation of this mixture will be zero. So let me take this concept further and see what do we mean by inversion in configuration. So inversion in configuration is a process wherein the configuration of the molecule is reversed during the course of the reaction. Therefore, we can say the product is of opposite enantiomeric form as compared to the reactant. That means if the reactant is having configuration R, the product will have configuration S. I would like to discuss this further by taking an example of SN2 reaction. So what do we mean by saying SN2 reaction? SN2 is a bimolecular nucleophilic substitution reaction. And I have discussed the mechanisms of all the reactions that I'm going to discuss with you in great details in my previous lectures. So we know that SN2 reaction is a bimolecular reaction in which both the nucleophile and the substrate are involved in the transition state. That means that the nucleophile and the substrate, when they are involved in the transition state, it means that the nucleophile is attacking the reactive center from one side and the leaving group is departing from the opposite side. So if we look into the stereochemistry of this reaction, for this I have taken the example of secondary butyl bromide. So what we find that since it is an SN2 reaction, in this case the bond formation and bond cleavage will take place simultaneously. That is, this carbon, again as you can see, is a chiral carbon since it is attached to four different groups. And this is the electrophilic site of the substrate, because bromine, being more electronegative than carbon, will pull the electrons towards itself through inductive effect, as a result of which this carbon is electrophilic now. The nucleophile will attack or make a bond with this carbon from the opposite side to which bromine atom is departing with the bonding pair of electrons. So we get this transition state in which we have partial bond formation and there is partial bond cleavage. So what happens, since here OH is making the bond with this chiral carbon from the side opposite to where bromine is leaving as an anion. So what we find is there is inversion in configuration at this carbon. So what do we observe? That in the substrate, supposing substrate is having R configuration, that is, it is R2-bromobutane, and the product is having S configuration, that is, it is S2-butanol. So configuration at the chiral carbon is inverted. So please remember, whenever we are carrying out SN2 reactions of chiral molecules, the reaction will be accompanied by inversion in configuration. In my previous lecture also, I had given you this analogy that we can compare SN2 reaction to an inverted umbrella. Imagine you are walking on a seashore and the wind is very strong. So what do we find? That the wind is very strong, as a result of which the head of the umbrella will be turned inside out and we get this configuration. So similarly, we can say that in SN2 mechanism the configuration is reversed. Now what do we mean by saying retention in configuration? Retention in configuration refers to a process wherein the configuration of the molecule is retained after the reaction. So that means we can say that retention of configuration means that symmetry of the substrate before and after the reaction is same. So if the symmetry of the reactant before the reaction is S, supposing if I say that the reactant is having a R configuration, then after reacting also the R configuration is retained. In this case, we will say there has been retention in configuration. For this, we have seen that in SNI mechanism, the reaction takes place by retention of configuration. Similarly, nucleophilic substitution reactions in which neighboring group participation is there, in those reactions also there is retention in configuration. Here I shall not be discussing the mechanisms of the reactions. We shall just be seeing the stereochemistry of the reaction. So whether the retention will take place or it will not take place will depend on the manner in which the bond cleavage takes place in the reactant. If the bond between the substituent and the chirality center is not broken, then retention will take place. For example, we are taking the example here of this molecule, and what we find that when the reaction is taking place, this bond is not cleaving. So the reaction will be accompanied by retention in configuration. This is again an optically active molecule, that is, it is a molecule of 2-butanol. This is your chiral carbon, which is attached to methyl group, hydrogen and a ethyl group. So what we find that the reaction, the bond cleavage between the chiral carbon and the atom attached to it does not break. So that means the reaction is not taking place at the chiral center. In this case, the bond will cleave between O and H. So that means in this case, reaction will be accompanied by retention in configuration. So when we carry out the reaction of 2-butanol with chlorotosilate, what we find is that this H group has been replaced by a tosylate group. So what do we get here? We get 2-butyl tosylate. And what you have to observe here is that in this case, the orientation of OH is on the right hand side. The methyl is here, hydrogen is going behind the viewer, that is behind the plane of the paper. This is facing towards the plane of the towards the viewer. This is in the plane of the paper. These bonds are in the plane of the paper. We have similar orientation here. That is, OH is all here in the plane of the paper. Similarly, this tosylate group is also in the plane of the paper. So the configuration here has not changed. So we say that this reaction has been accompanied by retention in configuration. So I have taken another reaction here in which the neighboring group participation takes place. But as I have said, I will not be going into the mechanism of the reaction. So this carbon is a chiral carbon since it is attached again to 4 different groups, NH2 amino group, carboxylic group, hydrogen and a hydroxymethyl group. So here again, this hydroxymethyl group is being replaced or is being substituted by a chloromethyl group here. But again, what we observe that in this case, the substitution of OH is at alpha carbon by a halogen atom, that is by a chlorine atom. Here the reaction is not taking place again at the chiral carbon. That is, bond between the carbon and the hydroxymethyl group is not cleaving. So this reaction will also be accompanied by retention in configuration. So again, I've written the net reaction is the replacement of hydroxymethyl group on the chiral center by chloromethyl group, and in the product, the chloromethyl group occupies the same site on the chiral center. As you can see here, it is having the same site as it is in the reactant. So now if we go into the mechanism, so we say, before I proceed further, that the reaction has occurred with retention of configuration, and this retention of configuration is there in the reaction because the chiral center in the substrate does not participate in the reaction. So let us look at the reaction here. We know that OH is not a good leaving group. So what happens when we carry out the reaction of this molecule, which is chiral in nature with HCl, dilute HCl, we find that first protonation of the OH group takes place to convert OH into a good leaving group. So the from here, now this OH group has been converted into OH2 positive. Now this will, the halide anion, that is the chloride anion, will attack the alpha carbon from one side, and the OH2, that is the OH, will depart as a water molecule from here, resulting in the formation of the product. So here what we observe, that the reaction has not taken place at the chiral center. It has rather taken place at the alpha carbon, that is the bond between carbon, the chiral carbon and the alpha carbon has not broken. So that means there will be retention in configuration. Now let us go into the third concept, that is, what is racemization? Racemic mixtures I have already discussed with you in great details in my previous lecture. And we know that the process of conversion of an enantiomer into a racemic mixture is known as racemization. And this racemization can be brought about by heat or by a chemical reaction of an optically active compound. And by doing so, that is, we are converting an optically active compound into a racemic form. So first of all, let us see what is a racemic mixture. Racemic mixture is optically inactive because it is equimolar mixture of two enantiomers. That is, it is equimolar mixture of the D and the L forms. And we know that enantiomers have same physical properties. That is, here the angle of rotation of the plane polarized light will be same, but the direction of rotation will be different. So if one is rotating the plane polarized light by say a degree, the other will rotate it by plus a, one is rotating by plus a degree, the other will rotate it by minus 8 degrees. So the net rotation will be 0 plus a minus a. So this racemic mixture is optically inactive. So when do we obtain a racemic mixture? First of all, you have to remember, a racemic mixture is always obtained whenever a chiral compound is synthesized in laboratory from achiral reagents. That is, in this case, the reactant will also be achiral, that is, it will also be optically inactive, as well as the substrate, that is, the will also be optically inactive. Why does this happen? This is due to the reason that there are equal probabilities for the formation of two enantiomers. And for this, I have taken example of formation of acetaldehyde cyanohydrin, which is a chiral compound, by addition of HCN, which is a achiral reagent, to acetaldehyde, which is again a achiral substrate. In this case, we get a 1:1 mixture of enantiomers of acetaldehyde cyanohydrin. So this is, since it is a 1:1 mixture, it is a racemic mixture. So as you can see on your screens, here I have carried out the reaction of acetaldehyde. And what we find that acetaldehyde is not optically active, because in this, this carbon is attached to three different groups. That is, it is attached to a methyl group, it is attached to hydrogen, and it is attached to two atoms of oxygen. This we've already discussed earlier on also, that if an carbon or if an atom is attached to the other atom by a double bond, we will consider those bonds to be duplicated. So that means this carbon is attached to two oxygens, so it is not chiral in nature. So when we bring about the reaction with HCl, we find, and the second thing that you have to keep in mind is that this carbon, since it has a double bond, it is sp2 hybridized. Since it is sp2 hybridized, the bond formation can take place from either of the phases. So in this case, since this nucleophile can attack from either phase of this carbon, we will have two products. That is, we can have L-acetaldehyde cyanohydrin and we can have D-acetaldehyde cyanohydrin, which will be formed in 1:1 mixture. So it will be optically inactive, that is, we'll get a racemic mixture. The last reaction that I would like to discuss quickly is the stereochemistry of SN1 reaction. We know when we carry out an SN1 reaction, it is a two-step reaction. And in the first step, we are getting carbocation as an intermediate. And now again, this carbocation is planar in nature. Now, since the starting compound is optically active, this planar carbocation will be attacked by the nucleophile by either of the sites. And when this happens, that is when if I carry out the reaction with methanol, we will get two products, since it can attack the planar carbocation from either of the faces. So we will get a product which is methoxy ether, in which the configuration has been inverted. Whereas in the first case, the configuration will be retained. So we get a racemic mixture. So in today's lecture, I have discussed the reactions in which inversion in configuration takes place, retention in configuration takes place, and racemization takes place. Thank you.